He made his professional debut on your undercard. That's a long time ago. It feels like forever ago, but it wasn't that long ago. Is there anything that you remember from that night, or were you just focused on your big show? But it was ironic that he made his professional debut on your undercard.
Well, just like this fight, you know, at that time I was really focused on my fight that I had in front of me. You know, I knew I watched Shakur Stevenson. I saw him in the Olympics. He's a great fighter from back then. He's turned into a great champion now. So I don't remember it all that day because I was really focused on my fight, just the same way I'm focused for this fight. Each and every fight, I take it very seriously. I just focus on one thing, just beating my opponent.
You guys have had some incredible camps. We've been privy to witness a lot of it. You have Canelo in your camp. You've had Bud in your camp. What was it like having Canelo in your camp, getting you ready for Saturday night?
It was great. Training besides Canelo, but it's not exciting. You know, there's always you can learn different things from fighters with great experience at this time. But it doesn't matter at the end of the day, because at the end of the day, the ones who are going to be inside the ring, it's going to be me and Shakur. So it doesn't matter if Canelo trained me or teaches me different things. At the end of the day, it's who has the bigger heart inside the ring, April 30th.
Shakur, what about you, man? Having Bud in your camp?
When Bud was in my camp, Bud came and we sparred each other. But I feel like it's a difference with his camp because he had Canelo with him every step of the way. Canelo was right there next to him, telling him how to hook, jab, and he was with each other every step of the way. So when I beat him, I'm gonna feel good beating him, Canelo, Eddie Reynoso, the whole team.
I asked him just to introduce you about how you made your pro debut. How exciting was that night for you when you made your pro debut? And did you ever envision this happening?
Yeah, most definitely. You gotta realize I was on his undercard, so I was focused on my fight, but I seen him fight in the main event, and I definitely was think about being on fight later on. I knew he was at the same weight, and it was always in my head that we was going to fight.
And this is for both of you. You know, your record in boxing, your opponents that you have both faced, very impressive. Jamel Herring, Nakatia, Conceição, Burchelt. Talk about how those fights have gotten you to this moment. We'll start with you, Oscar.
Well, those fights have built us up and built myself up to have confidence in and the experience that I have right now to be the fighter that I am. So, yes, it was tough at first, but now, you know, we're in this great position. You know, all those great fights that I've had has turned me into the fighter that I am right now with a lot of experience. And just, you know, continue building my career, continue building my legacy. You know, we all want to be the best. We all want to be the top pound-for-pound list. But to be in that list, you got to beat fighters, like in this case. You know, to fight like Shakur Stevenson. So that's definitely the fight that we have to win to be in our big step to become one of the top pound for pound.